Hello friends, in today's lecture we have to see the indirect methods of the level measurement, and in that we have to focus on the capacitive level measurement and the ultrasonic level measurement. Let us see what is capacitance level measurement. The capacitance level sensors are used for the wide variety of the solids, aqueous and the organic liquids and the slurries. This technique is frequently referred as RF radio frequency signals applied to the capacitance circuit. Now in this, the sensors can be designed to sense the material with dielectric constant as low as 1.1 and as high as 88, that is for water. So, the dielectric material must be having the range in between 1.8 to 88. So, 1.1 it is for the coke or fly ash, and 88 that is for water. Now, in this, the sludges, slurries such as a dehydrated cake, sewage slurry, which must be having the dielectric constant approximately 50. And the liquid chemicals such as quicklime with a dielectric constant of 90 can also be sensed through this capacitance level measurement. Now in this capacitor level measurement, the dual probe capacitance level sensors can be used to sense the interference between two immiscible liquids with substantially different dielectric constants. So what is there? There must be the dual probe capacitance level which is used for the sensing the substantially different dielectric constants. Since these capacitance level sensors are electronics devices, the phase modulation and the use of high frequencies makes the sensor suitable for applications in which the dielectric constant are similar. So how can we use these capacitance level sensors? So this can be used in which the dielectric constants are similar. Why? Because the phase modulation and the higher frequencies will make it suitable for that. Now let us focus on the working principle of the capacitance level measurement system. Here you can see the diagram over here. Now what do you have in that? It is having a metal tank which is grounded reference. It is having non-conductive insulating medium over here. This is air. And this is pipe probe you can see. And these are the plates of the capacitor. So it is having the capacitance level measurement. Now let us see the working principle of that. So the principle of the capacitive level measurement is based on the change of the capacitance. So as the change in the capacitance level, there is a level of the liquid will get changed. An insulated electrodes acts as an one plate of the capacitor and the tank wall, and acts as the other plate. So how these two plates are distinguished? An insulated electrode, it acting as the one plate of the capacitor, and the tank wall, it is acting as the other plate. The capacitance depends upon the fluid liquid. An empty tank has the lower capacitance while the filled tank has higher capacitance. A simple capacitor consists of two electrode plates separated by small thickness of insulator such as solid, liquid, gas or vacuum. These insulators are also called as dielectrics. Now in this, the value of C, that is the capacitance, is depending upon the dielectric used, area of the plate, and also between the distance between the plates. So this capacitance C value is given by E, Ka divided by D, where E is the electric field, A is the area and D is the distance. So this works on the principle of the capacitive level measurement. is based on the change of the capacitance. Now, how the measurement is done in this capacitance type of level measurement? So, the measurement is made by applying the RF signal between the conductive probes and the vessel walls. As we have seen, that vessel wall is acting as the one plate of the capacitor and the electrode, that is conductive probe, is acting as the another plate of the capacitor. And in between that, there is a formation of the electric field. Now, the RF signal results in very low current, which is flowing through the dielectric process terminals in the tank from probe to the vessel wall. When the level in the tank drops, the dielectric constant drops, causing a drop in the capacitance reading and a minute drop in the current flow. Now, how it is happening? When the level in the tank drops, the dielectric constant drops, causing the drop in the capacitance reading. And this is how a minute drop in the current flow. So, this change is detected by the level switch internal circuitry and translated into the change in the relay state of the liquid level switch in the point of level detection. So, this is how the level of the liquid is detected. So, how the level of the liquid is detected? First of all, we have to apply the RF signal. RF signal causing the low current flow through the dielectric process material in the tank and the probe to the vessel wall. And when the liquid in the tank drops, the dielectric constant drops, the causing the drop in the capacitance reading. And this change is detected by the level switch's internal circuitry and translated a change in the relay state of the level switch in case of point level detection. So, in case of continuous level detectors, the output is not relay state but scaled analog signal. So, this level measurement is divided into three categories, that is measurement of conductive material, measurement of conductive material and the non-conductive material, and non-contact measurement. So, for the measurement of non-conductive material, the liquid level is divided into three categories: measurement of non-conductive material, measurement of conductive material and non-contact measurement. So, this is how the capacitance type of level measurement is used. Now, let us see what are the advantages related to the capacitive level measurement. So, it is versatile, reliable and inexpensive. It requires the minimal maintenance. It consists no moving parts. So, it is simple in construction. It is easy to clean. It gives you the good range of the measurement, that is from few centimeter to the 100 meters. It can be designed for the high temperature and the pressure applications. Now, let us see what are the applications of the capacitive level measurement. So, it is used for the liquids. It is used for the powered and the granular solids. These liquid metals are very high temperature. This can be used for the liquefied gases at very low temperature. Again, this can be used for the corrosive materials like hydrofluoric acid. It can be used for very high pressure industrial processes. So, these are some applications related to the capacitive level measurement. Now, there must be some disadvantages related to the capacitive level measurement. So, the light density materials under 20 lb per feet material and the material with particle size exceeding 1/2 inch in the diameter can be problem due to their low value of the dielectric constant. So, it may cause by the large amount of airspace between the particles. So, for these conditions, we cannot get the accurate results for this capacitive level measurement. Now next is the ultrasonic level measurement. Now let us see, what do you mean by ultrasonic level measurement? So you can see the diagram in this ultrasonic level measurement. This is what the ultrasonic level transmitter, which is connected above the tank. Now here there are four distances which is to be measured. Distance A, that is from the bottom to the upper level of the distance. So this A is called as empty distance. Distance B, it is called as distance of the sensor from fluid level. Distance C is the fluid level. So this distance C is giving us the fluid level, whereas distance D is the measurement span. And this distance between A and this B, it is called as blocking distance. Now let us see how does it work. So these ultrasonic level detectors are used the principle of reflection of acoustic wave from liquid to vapor phase and vapor to the liquid phase. So which principle is used? It is used on the acoustic wave from liquid to the vapor phase and vapor to the liquid phase. Now in this, the ultrasonic level transmitter is fixed at the top of the tank, half filled with liquid. The tank is half filled with the liquid. The reference level of all the measurement is the bottom of the tank. The level to be detected is marked C, and B is the distance of the ultrasonic sensor from the liquid level. Now in this, ultrasonic pulse signals are transmitted from the transmitter and it is reflected back to the sensor. Now the travel time of the ultrasonic pulse from the sensor to the target and back is calculated. Now the level C can be found by multiplying the half of this time with the speed of the sound in the air. The measuring unit final results can be centimeters, feet or the inches. Now how to find out the level? So level can be calculated as the speed of the sound in the air multiplied by time delay divided by 2. So this is how we can find out the level of the liquid. So in this, the ultrasonic pulse signals are transmitted from the transmitter and it is reflected back to the sensors. And in between these timing, we have to measure the travel time of the ultrasonic pulse from the sensor to the target and back is calculated. From that time, you can find out the level of the liquid. Now, once the transmitter is programmed with the bottom reference of the applications, usually the bottom of the tank, the liquid level is calculated by the microprocessor. So the basic equation for the calculation of the tank level is tank height minus distance. Now let us see what are the advantages related to the ultrasonic transmitters. So these ultrasonic transmitters are easy to install on the empty tanks and tank containing the liquids. Now the setup is very much simple, and those devices with onboard programming capability can be configured in minutes. As there is no contact with the media and no moving parts, the devices are virtually maintenance free. Weighted materials are usually an inert fluoropolymer and resistance to the corrosion from the condensing vapor. Because of this device is non-contacting, the level measurement is unaffected by the changes in the liquid density, dielectric viscosity, and it performs well on the aqueous liquid and many chemicals. Changes in the process temperature will change the speed of the ultrasonic pulse through the space above liquid, but built-in temperature compensation automatically corrected this. So these changes in the process pressure do not affect the measurement. Now, what are the limitations of this ultrasonic level measurement? These ultrasonic transmitters rely on the pulse being unaffected during the flight time. The liquids which forms the heavy vapors, stem, vapor layers should be avoided. As the pulse needs air to travel through, vacuum applications are not possible. Now, these material construction generally limit the process temperature around 158 degree Farad, that is from 70 degree, and pressure to the 3 bars, that is 43 psig. The condition of the liquid surface is also important here. Some turbulences can be tolerated, but foaming will often damp out the return echo. So, if the return echo is damped out, the time, travel time will not get calculated accurately. The obstructions in the tank, such as pipes, strengthening, bars, agitators, will cause the false echoes. But most transmitters have sophisticated software algorithms to allow the masking or ignoring these kind of echoes. So, this is all about the capacitive type of level measurement and the ultrasonic type of level measurements we have seen, its applications we have seen. Thank you.